you know, the way you're going to see them, you just go on the general kind of, they go to single, will one day be married, amen? And by the grace of God, marriage will never be single.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Now, I'm just trying to see where I'm to stop, because I don't want to get into trouble. You must be a baby. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your presence. Father, we give you praise, and we thank you. Now, the entrance of your word through Christ and understanding. Above all, today we ask for wisdom. And we ask that your name be glorified, and the enemy be what?
Glorified.
And the name of the Lord Jesus be glorified, and the enemy be
glorified.
Let's give the Lord a clap of praise. About a year ago, I kind of opened with that. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 20, verse 6, it says, a faithful man who can find. I'll repeat again. In Proverbs chapter 20, verse 6, it says, a faithful man who can find. In other words, that faithful man is a rare commodity. And if something is rare, glory to God, you have to be pointed in the right direction to where it is. Not only do you have to be pointed in the right direction, you have to have favor. Amen? You know, some people say sometimes it's not what you know, it's who you know. That great opportunity for you. And there's one favorite friend of mine that it didn't originate from me, I just saw it on the billboard, one of those things was, he said, opportunity favors the prepared mind. God favors me.
Opportunity.
Favor. The prepared mind. Glory to God. I've done some of it. Then in Proverbs 31 verse 10, it says, a virtuous woman who can find. Now let me just back up again. Proverbs 20 verse 6, so that was just a B part of the scripture. It actually says, in my version, it says, any man can declare his loyalty. Because they have loyal they are, how faithful they are. But a faithful man who can find. In other words, everybody wears a mark. But the true person, you can't find. They said a virtuous woman, Proverbs 31 verse 10, says a virtuous woman who can find. He said her worth is more than rubies. It might be translated as jewels. Glory to God. You find out that it says something about a man. He's faithful. And he's rare. It says something about a woman. She's rare. Glory to God. And one of the things that happens with people today is that when we're looking for that spouse, we look from the wrong candle. You know, we watch Hollywood. Yesterday we were watching this movie, with Kelly Rowland, who was in it, who was distracted, who was in the guy. We'll tell you more about that. And she was looking for a real guy. Somebody, an ordinary Joe, not somebody who is
pretentious.
Somebody, no, he doesn't have to be rich. And this guy was pretending to be something. And he was not. Glory to God. What has become? They have an image of who that person has to be. Well, you can't find a wife by yourself. That's the most important thing. Let's go back to the Bible. The Bible says, Adam was a thief. Amen? And God brought this woman to him. And as soon as he saw it, that means while you're there. You know what he says? The bone of my bone and the flesh of my flesh. In actual fact, in the original language, it was something like, wow, he's hot. Glory to God. The man had a mini revival when he saw a beautiful woman. Glory to God. He saw her, and he saw, he didn't just see her beauty. He saw somebody who was comparable to him. And what the word says comparable, well, the actual word for the woman is actually in the Greek translation of the Hebrew word is the word parakletos. Where do we get the word paraclete from? And it's the word used for the Holy Spirit.
I'm knowing some words.
See, a lot of us want to get married. We don't even know what the role of a wife should be. We don't know what the role of a husband should be. And the role is not something that you act, it's something that you are.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Lord, have mercy. You see, to be, you see, when I pray for people who want to get married, I pray for the anointing for them to be a wife, the anointing for them to be a husband. Because the Bible, the anointing actually means the ability to perform.
Yes.
Glory of God. And so what happens here, if we find two people looking for each other, what they're looking for is a rare commodity.
Hmm.
When something is rare, it doesn't mean you don't have copies of the rare commodity.
Hmm.
In actual fact, is that when something is rare, you have abundance of copies of the original.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Lord, have mercy. You're looking for an original matter. But what is guiding your judgment is the abundance of copies. And so therefore, when we're looking, we have to look for the right intelligence. And the best way to look, first of all, is to understand what is the role. If I'm looking for something, I don't know what it is. What it can do. What is the virtuous woman? I'm looking for a wife. What is the virtuous woman? Glory to God. I'm looking for a husband. What does a faithful man entail? A faithful man doesn't just mean because we're women. When we're talking about somebody being faithful or slut, most times that attempt, what a woman means from what a man means by trust is two different things. Not just that, say, when a woman says, I can't trust him, it means that this guy is going to cheat on me. Is that what I want to do? Come on up today. Yes, yes. And not just that, say, when a man says, I can't trust this woman, it's not usually that a woman will cheat on us. Is that if I share some secret with this woman, when we have an argument, she won't
use it against
me. Use it against me. That's one of the major reasons why that comes up. Because when a man makes a mistake, he doesn't want to be told, I told you so. Let me tell you, married women, can I just give you a clue right now? Your husband will make a mistake. He will believe he is making the right choice. He's making a decision for the family. He has made that choice. And you know that 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 that choice is a wrong choice. He's going to fall flat on his face. He's going to fall flat on his face. It's not for you to wait for him to fall back in his face and go, I told you so. Because that's not a virtuous woman. A virtuous woman looks for the good of the man. In 1 Corinthians chapter 11, Paul was talking about something about women covering their hair, and he said something. He said, the woman is the glory of the man. In other words, the beauty of the man is seen in the woman. So when a man sees a woman, he's going to be with this woman beautiful. And it's not beautified in the sense of make me look good, you know, a trophy wife, no? He's talking about a woman that indeed will look out for me. A woman who will invest in me. First of all, I'm testing myself, but I'm going to say this. The first thing you've got to do is you're looking for a spouse. The very, very first thing you've got to do is you've got to invest in yourself. When you make an investment, you make an investment in yourself so that people can make a withdrawal. You've got to invest in yourself. They ask questions to everybody, what are they looking for in a woman? And everybody says what they want. Nobody says what they can give. Because you're concentrating on what you're going to get. You're not spending time investing in yourself to give. And you know the Bible says it is more blessed to give than to do what? Receive. I know. Oh my God, he's here. Very, very blessed. I know what it means to be blessed. It's empowered to prosper. To be empowered to prosper.